Since the news first broke of Liam Payne's death on Wednesday evening, fans here in Buenos Aires have gathered continuously outside the hotel where he was staying and where he fell to his death from that third floor balcony. People have been leaving flowers, writing messages, lighting candles.
The candles are still burning outside of Liam Payne's hotel in Argentina. Police said a preliminary autopsy suggested the 31-year-old had died from external and internal bleeding. They said everything indicated that the musician was alone when the fall happened. Hotel staff said they found the room wrecked and in total disorder, with broken items littered across the floor, along with medications including clonazepam, a drug that can be used to treat anxiety. The circumstances surrounding Liam's death remain murky, but what's clear is that millions of people all over the world are heartbroken.
I think overwhelmed is definitely the right word for it.
My friends from Bangladesh even messaged me this morning and we were all in complete disbelief.
Liam was my favorite. He had such an incredible voice.
I can say that One Direction made me who I am, but specifically Liam made me who I am.
All of us One Direction fans kept hoping deep down that someday they would reunite.
I still remember saying to my dad, these guys will outlive the Beatles.
This outpouring of grief got us thinking, why do we mourn celebrities when we don't know them directly? On today's episode, we're going to hear from fans and a psychotherapist to understand why Liam's death is weighing so heavy on so many. I'm William Lee Adams, and this is What in the World from the BBC World Service. If you're following the story, then you're probably hearing a lot about The X Factor, the show where Liam got his big break. In case you don't know, The X Factor was a reality singing contest in the UK launched by Simon Cowell in 2004. Here to tell us more about Liam and One Direction is Bonnie McLaren. She's an entertainment reporter based here in London. Bonnie, hi.
Hello.
So it's a difficult time for One Direction fans, for Liam Payne fans, but I'm hoping we can zoom out for people who may not be familiar with the artist Liam Payne. Who was he?
Yeah, so for people who weren't familiar, Liam Payne was one of the five members of One Direction, one of the world's biggest boy bands of all time. One Direction met on X Factor, they were put together, and then they went on to become this absolutely huge, stratospheric boy band, probably more so than any of them or anybody ever imagined. And after that, Liam had, like the rest of them, he embarked on his own solo career and released an album and released successful singles. And yeah, that's Liam Payne.
And we should say, in this group, there are some other very big names. Could you walk us through them?
Yeah, of course. All of them are so famous. We've got, of course, Harry Styles, Louis Tomlinson, Zayn, Malik, Niall, Horan. They're all completely successful solo artists in their own right, as well as Liam was as well.
And all of their individual success, it's almost like it buoyed everyone else's because they were part of this iconic group. How far did Liam go on his own?
Well, Liam went really, really far. I mean, looking at some stats, he sold 18 million singles, 2.4 million albums of his debut. Like, that's big numbers. Probably most known for his first single, Strip That Down with Quavo, which was a huge hit. And he was planning to do a second album, which unfortunately now isn't going to happen, which is really sad.
It's been really interesting and heartening to see how celebrities all over the world, not just in the UK, have really responded to his death. There's been this outpouring of grief. For people who don't live in the UK, could you give a sense of what the reaction's been like here?
It's just been absolutely huge. I mean, he was so young. He was only 31. It came so out of the blue and it's been so shocking. And he was such a big part of like UK celebrity culture in this country. Like, he was an extremely known face. And, you know, it's just really shocked the entertainment industry here with people that knew him as a teenager on X Factor and people that have, you know, worked with him in the music and TV industries.
And people in the UK, more so than anywhere else in the world, have really watched him grow from boy to man. Do you think that informs some of the grief we're seeing.
Completely, yeah. I mean, he first auditioned for X Factor when he was 14. And then it was a couple of years later that he auditioned again and then got put with One Direction. So most of his life, he has been in the public eye in this country. And if you were a young fan of One Direction, then you also grew up with Liam. It's a very emotional connection, I think, for a lot of fans.
And Bonnie, what about you? Did Liam influence your career trajectory and becoming a journalist?
Yes, I mean, I absolutely, if you couldn't tell, I adored One Direction as a teenager. I absolutely loved them. My walls were top to bottom, plastered in posters of all of them. I used to spend all of my time on Twitter tweeting all of them. I mean, Liam followed me, which was amazing. That was great when I was a teenager. I was obsessed with One Direction and chart music as a teenager, and I was like, wow, wouldn't it be really cool to have a career where I could speak to these people and find out more about their jobs and what they were releasing and all of that. So I decided I wanted to be a journalist, and I somehow managed to do that. And yeah, and I was lucky enough that I've interviewed Liam before, and I've interviewed Niall as well. Liam was the first member of One Direction that I ever met, and it was so amazing. It was a complete dream come true for me.
Bonnie mentioned the band's solo projects there. That was after One Direction split in 2016 after a brief hiatus. Zayn Malik had quit a year before. Both Liam and Zayn have said publicly that stress played a big role in them stepping away. And throughout his career, Liam was pretty open about his struggles with being in the spotlight. We're going to hear more from Bonnie shortly, but first, I wanted to share more of a sense of how fans around the world have been reacting. Bintelmran is 22 and lives in Pakistan. Bintelmran, how did the news of Liam's death impact you?
It was a very shocking news for us. For hours, I couldn't perceive it. I just couldn't believe that it actually happened. We've seen him from years, we have been following him, and just a sudden news of his death was devastating. At the age of 31, we just couldn't believe it.
And where were you when you found out this horrible news?
It was pretty late in our country at that time. I was about to sleep when my sister came to me. She saw a post about it, and she was worried if it's real or fake. She came to me and asked me, is it real or fake? And I was just shocked to hear that. I thought it could be a fake news. I was wishing for it to be a fake news. I literally went to the pages and pages after every fan page. I just wanted to see if it's real. I couldn't accept it. It was total denial for me.
And your fellow fans, are you guys comforting each other? What types of discussions are you having?
I just texted my best friend after hearing the news. She was so shocked. She thought that I could be pranking her, but she knew that this is like the worst kind of thing I could prank her about. She was so shocked. She started crying. My sister started crying, and I didn't even know how to comfort her. She's younger than me. And we just met and talked to each other for hours and hours about the old memories and all the stuff he's been going through, that we've been going through. And I guess this is the only thing we can do for now.
And I'm speaking to you from London. Liam was, of course, British. Why do you think Pakistani fans in particular responded to Liam?
Pakistani fan, as much as any other fan in this world, we need our comfort place. It's a global thing. People need escape from reality, and One Direction was one of the sources, one of the places where we can go and get comfort.
As someone who's in the Liam Payne, the One Direction fan community, running a fan page, do you feel extra responsibility to honor his legacy?
Of course I do. We run these fan pages for people to remind generations to know that who One Direction is, who One Direction was, who Liam Payne was, what was his legacy. And this is what the fan pages are for.
Bintelmran, thank you for sharing that.
I'm very glad that people are literally giving this attention. Thank you so much for doing this.
Bonnie, back to you now. What was it like to be a One Direction fan when they were at their peak?
Quite honestly, it was incredible, and there was an incredible sense of community And it was around about the time that Twitter had just become a thing. And all of the members were really responsive with their fans. They were communicating with their fans often, and there was such a community of all of us together on the internet, making friends with each other, but also being able to interact with this band that we all completely loved. And because their reach was so global, you know, it was such a huge community of people. It wasn't like it was just a tiny UK-based fan base. So there were fans everywhere, all over the world. And that was a really special thing to be part of as a teenager. And I always found it to be a really positive and nice community environment. And, you know, I'm still friends with people that, or I know people that I used to follow who were One Direction fans as teenagers, which is wild, but also like extremely special, I think.
Bonnie, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
We've heard how fans are feeling, and they're really heartbroken. I wanted to find out a little more about why fans feel so sad when celebrities die, even if they didn't know them personally. So I reached out to Joshua Miles, a psychotherapist based in London. Joshua, hi.
Hello, hi.
We've seen an outpouring of grief on social media, in clips on the internet. Fans really upset about the death of Liam Payne. Presumably, many of these people didn't know him personally. So why do we grieve the death of celebs?
I think it's a very good question. I think it might have something to do with the kind of the increase of social media, these Instagram pages or X pages or whatever they might be, sort of offer people a window into a famous person's life. I think there can be a real attachment, even though, as you said, they don't know them personally. And it almost feels like it is someone that they know personally because they listen to their music, they read their posts, they look at their content, they feel they really do have a connection. I think another factor could be that somehow grief becomes a bit misplaced. Perhaps someone has had a loss, perhaps a death, or perhaps some other loss of a job that is sort of brought up in the understanding of the death of somebody. So what I mean by misplaced is, does it really belong elsewhere? And I think the death of a celebrity offers a lot of community. You know, as you said, you know, many fans all over the world that people can talk through, understand, sort of share with one another. That would be what I would say. I mean, I think it's more complicated than that, but in a sort of a nutshell, that's what I would say.
A lot of fans seem to invest sort of psychological capital. Mm-hmm. They invest themselves in these mm-hmm. celebrities. And I guess when a celebrity passes away, could it almost be like a part of themselves is dying as well?
Mm. Yeah, it's a really good way of putting it. I think it could be almost like a part of their life has died.
Mm.
Do you see what I mean? If you're someone who follows celebrity content quite heavily or sort of is invested in it, then the person who's producing that content dies, then it is like a part of your life has died. Even if it's, albeit for a period of time until you recover and sort of feel okay again. And we can look back in history at these sorts of things. It's not just since social media there have been celebrities who have died and there's been huge outpourings. I mean, when Princess Diana died, it was just ginormous, right? There's no scale of mourning like that in the UK particularly. So it's not just because of social media. I think it is the investment in somebody's life. And of course, you associate that with the creations that they make, the music they write, the videos they put out, the things that they say. Perhaps they stand for a certain issue that you also align with, or perhaps they support a charity that you're interested in, for example. So I think people get very intertwined, sort of in their mind at least, with celebrities.
Joshua, thank you so much for explaining that.
You're welcome.
If you're feeling overwhelmed right now, Joshua had some good tips to help you cope. Firstly, seek professional help if you feel you need it. Or it might help just to talk to a friend. It's important to give yourself time and space to grieve. You should remember that grief isn't linear. One day you might feel bad, the next day a bit better. It's a process. And finally, Joshua says that doing something creative, like writing in a journal, could also help. And as you'll probably know, you can still celebrate your favorite artist by listening to their music. And as we sat down to record this, Niall Horan wrote on Instagram that Liam's death doesn't feel real. In a statement, he said, "Liam had an energy for life and a passion for work that was infectious. He was the brightest in every room and always made everyone feel happy and secure." If you want to stay across the latest with this story, you can visit the BBC News website. I'm William Lee Adams. This is What in the World from the BBC World Service. Thank you for listening.